when Indra's weapon hit and Vayu demanded all devas to bless him, all came and blessed him, and you see a Mahavir in Hanuman. This is one version of the stories. Now you see the story. For children, it's such a beautiful story that Hanuman was flying across and Indra hit him, the chin broke, he fell down. Vayu put his foot down and said, come and bless. And everyone blessed him. How much we can think on this story? That he was heading towards sun. Can anyone reach the sun? Particularly in that country where people knew about sun. The distance of the sun. It's not illiterate. It is all absolutely educated people who knew this. And to them, so they sit and think, oh, there is so much more to it. Going towards sun, what does it mean? What all sun stands for? That he went towards it. There's another version of the same story where Hanuman went and caught the sun. That is also true. You can catch. But you have to understand Hanuman for that. Not Hanuman as a body. Hanuman, he who has destroyed pride, is divine. Divinity is beyond sun. Divinity can hold sun. Think. As a body, you can't catch the sun. But Hanuman, when you say the person who has taken away the vanity out of him, there is no ego there. That means what? He is divine. The divine can grasp everything. And is it not true? Divinity is more powerful than the sun. That's why Gurudev says, it is this light which makes that shine. It's the light, the self within, makes the sun shine. You can catch the sun. So there's a meaning to it, that Hanuman went and caught the sun. Naturally, when he caught the sun, the whole thing was getting dark. Like a child, it's a prank played. And all devas came and said, we know your power. Don't tease us so much. Please release it. And then Hanuman said, okay. You want the sun to be released? Here I let the sun free. When sun was free, energy came back, light came back, people were happy. Otherwise, Tino Lok Andiaro, all three worlds went into darkness. Without knowledge, life is in darkness only. In ignorance, what are we doing? In darkness only. So in this verse, we see him saying, oh Lord Hanuman, once you flew up to the sun to grab and swallow it, as if it was an apple or a sweet ball, to appease your hunger. Due to your childish prank, darkness engulfed the whole world, and no one knew how to release the sun. The devatas came and beseeched you. You released the sun and saved the world from chaos. Thanks to that knowledge which came and makes our life meaningful. Absence of this knowledge, Brahma Vidya, what life, what meaning do we have in our life? How sad. Many people live that way, isn't it? You ask them, what do you want in life? What goals people have in life? I should do well in my life. My children should do well in my life. Then what happens? Both have done well. After that? Now nothing. What else? Without any suffering, I should die. That's all, isn't it? I must do well. My children must do well. Then, without any suffering, I must die. This is our goal. Now, this word well has to be well defined. What do you mean well? Define it well. Let us see. What you call as well, I must do well in my life. Where do you draw a line? There'll be always someone who has done better than you. Or what you thought is well done, Your child may think this was very ordinary, I have to do much more. So you don't know. So what is that maximum goal people keep in life? I must do well and my children should do well. Can that be only a goal of life? That must be a way of life. Mahavir must be the goal of life. Doing well in life is gaining all the five qualities. Fearlessness. Face anything which life offers. Worth living. Vidyavir, have knowledge about truth so that we can contemplate on it. Dayavir, help others. Dhanavir, give us charity what you have. Tyagavir, to all that you achieve, be detached. That's achievement, isn't it? Much better goal in life. You see, when we set our minds to become a Mahavir, what a different goal we get in life. How beautiful is that life if we gain all these qualities? Staying here, not being attached. Achieving things, but not attached to it. Mahavir. Fearless. Knowledge. Compassion. Charity. Detachment. That can be the goal. So when we sit and think about the verse, a story for children, it's so brilliant. And for adults, so much is left to contemplate. Aim for the highest. Don't compromise in aiming for the small. So he says, the devatas came and beseeched you, and you released the sun and saved the world from chaos. And then Tulsidas ji puts a question. This question is very important. O Lord Hanuman, who in the world does not know that your name is Sankat Mochan? Namutivar. That your name itself is Sankat Mochan. Sankat Mochan means deliverer from sorrows, liberator from sorrows. Who in the world does not know that you are the liberator of sorrows? Please think. If sorrows chase us in life, seek Hanuman. Seek Mahavir. Hanuman, it should not be, I went there and I gave him little butter. I am seeking Hanuman. Your butter, Hanuman, is not pleased. You can't butter him. I have buttered Hanuman every day. Mahavir. Seek Mahavir. When we seek Mahavir, the five qualities, sorrows do go. Liberator from sorrows. It's our life. Why can't we do it? Why can't we become free from sorrow once for all? Liberate ourselves from it. Why should we keep slipping from one sorrow to another? One sorrow to another. Again and again. Again and again. How many years have gone through? Again the same condition. So Hanuman, here Tulsidas ji puts that question. Who on earth does not know, O Hanuman, you are the liberator of, liberator from sorrows. If sorrows are suffocating us, we can find a way out. And that can happen through seeking Mahavir. Seek Hanuman, Sankat Mochan. Everyone knows, O Hanuman, you are the liberator from sorrows. This is the meaning of the first verse. So please chant the second verse.
Bali ki tras kapis base giri.
Bali ki tras kapis base giri.
Jat Mahaprabhu pant niharo.
Jat Mahaprabhu pant niharo.
Choki Mahamuni sap diyo tab.
Choki Mahamuni sap diyo tab.
Chahiye kon bichar bicharo.
Chahiye kon bichar bicharo.
Kedvij rup livaye Mahaprabhu.
Kedvij rup livaye Mahaprabhu.
So tum das ke sok nivaro.
So tum das ke sok nivaro.
को नहीं जानत है जग में कभी
को नहीं जानत है जग में कभी
संकट मोचन नाम तिहारो
संकट मोचन नाम तिहारो
टुगेदर
बाली की त्रास कपीस बसे गिरी जात महाप्रभु पंत निहारो चौकी महामुनि साप दियो तब चाहिए कौन विचार बिचारो कै द्विज रूप लिवाय महाप्रभु सो तुम दास के शोक निवारो को नहीं जानत है जग में कभी संकट मोचन नाम तिहारो संकट मोचन नाम तिहारो
वी ऑल नो द स्टोरी ऑफ वाली एंड सुग्रीवा बोथ ब्रदर्स वाली लॉस्ट वैल्यूज एंड देयरफॉर द नॉलेज व्हिच ही गेन्ड earlier by not living up to the values the knowledge what is right and wrong was lost it so happened that there was a demon by name Dundubi challenged Vali and the fight was going on for some time and Vali was such a powerful warrior who could destroy anybody soon but in this particular combat it was not Vali was not coming out and the fight was happening in a cave and Sugriv his brother was sitting out and thinking with the other monkeys saying how long this fight is going on and nobody can challenge Vali this long so this combat is so we do not know what is the outcome of this combat if Vali is struggling to fight Dundubi and it looks obvious because it took so much time for him and he's not out still what if Dundubi comes out after killing Vali what will be our condition in common interest of everyone Sugriv decided bring all kinds of boulders so all the monkeys went out and picked up all kinds of boulders and closed the mouth of the cave and Vali didn't turn up nor Dundubi turned up So that Dundubi doesn't come out, and that's the idea, intention. He closed it up, and he was living. Naturally, the kingdom without a king. So Sugriva was made the king, and after some time, a month or so later, Vali came out. That means Dundubi was killed. Vali came out, and Vali thought Sugriva absorbed his kingdom. Took it away cleverly and he said you don't deserve to live I have to kill you he tried explaining he said nothing doing and not only he chased him out he was very keen that he would kill him go and kill Sugriv but in this process when the fight happened and Vali came out dragging Dundubi's body And naturally, when people saw Vali, they were so happy and all that. And he was drunk. Vali got drunk fully, took Dundubi's body as a show of his victory, flung it out, and it went and fell in Matanga Rishi's ashram. The body, what he threw. Went and fell. Dundubi's dead body fell in Matanga Rishi's ashram. And Matanga Rishi naturally called out and saying, who did this? Come out. I want to know who did it. And Vali drunk fully, with all arrogance, he was talking to Matanga Rishi, saying, what does it matter and all that. And Matanga Rishi said, if you come into this place once again, you will die. That's my curse on you. There was one mountain called Rishyamukh. If you come here, you will die. So this curse happened. And only person who knew about it, apart from Vali, Matanga Rishi, is Hanuman. Hanuman knew, okay, there is a curse on Vali. And when Dundubi, when Vali came out and then threw out, chased away Sugriv, Sugriv was running from one place to another. Wherever he went, Vali chased him with one notion that I'm going to kill you. Wherever he went, Vali was coming. So, and Sugriv was running from place to place and Vali was chasing him. That's why when Sugriv meets Lord Ram, he describes the topography of that whole place. Ram was surprised by geographical knowledge of Sugriv, saying, how do you know these areas? He said, my brother, wherever I went, he chased me. I know all these places I was hiding. And he was miserable, actually running for life from one place to another. At that time, finally, Hanumanji stopped Sugriv and he said, where are you running? I'll tell you, you come and stay here. Very close to Vali's place, you come and stay. In Rishyamukh Parvat, you said, are you trapping me or what? He would kill me. He said, you come and stay here, nothing will happen. And Sugriv went and stayed in that mountain called Rishyamukh. And Hanuman told him, there's a curse of Matanga Rishis. Vali would not step in here, don't worry. If Vali steps in here, he is courting death. So, Vali never came there. And in that Rishyamukh Parvat, Sugriv was taking asylum. Now see, such nice stories for children. Or wherever he went and they had two brothers fighting and all that. And then there's a curse. If you go there, you will die. Rishyamukh means what? The term indicates facing Rishi. Mukha, mouth of the Rishi. Face the mouth of the Rishi. Face knowledge. Vali will not come there. What does Vali mean? Vali means karma phala. Karma phala will chase us wherever we go. It will not spare. Wherever we go, karma phala will chase us. The only place it can't enter is Rishyamukha. That means satsang. That's the only place karma phala cannot come. Aneka janma samprapta karma bandha vidahine. Atma jnana pradanena tasmai sri gurave namaha. Aneka janma, countless births, janma, karma accumulated in countless births gets destroyed by atma jnana. In satsang we gain that knowledge. Once we gain that knowledge, karma phala stops coming. Till then it follows, not follows, chases. It chases. But once we have learned the gained knowledge, we know how to act in the world, how to work in the world, how to perform actions in the world. With right intention, we would perform. Karma phala cannot come. So that way, Sugriv was taking shelter in that mountain. And that's when Lord Ram and Hanuman and Lakshman comes there. And Hanuman comes up to meet Lord Ram, and then he introduces him to Sugriv. More details about that further we will take up tomorrow.